Hey there, it's Marlene from imagemaven.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how to tether your Lumix G9 directly to your computer, and also how to use that with Luminar AI and Luminar 4. Let's go! The first thing you need to do is download the Lumix Tether app. You don't want the one for streaming in this case. Make sure you choose this one here, the Lumix Tether Download Program. Now, one thing you need to do right off the bat is just make sure that your camera is supported. And currently, these are the cameras that are supported. I'm using the Lumix G9, so I know that it's going to work for me. So you go to the download at the bottom here. Also, make sure that your computer is supported. And download. Now, one thing you will have to do is put your camera model as well as the serial number from your camera into here before you can download it. And then you just follow the instructions. It's fairly easy. Once your software is downloaded, you can connect your computer to your camera. To connect your camera to the computer, you will need the USB cord that came with your camera. It's used for charging, as well as you can use it to download photos from your memory cards. Now, if it's not long enough for what you need, you will have to buy a longer cable. For example, if you're shooting portraits, I find this cable is a bit short. Next, go into your camera menus and make sure that the USB mode is set up for tethering. Okay, launch Lumix Tether. Now, in my case, I don't need the latest version. I'm just going to use current version, which is 1.7, which does work with the Lumix G9. And then I have to set up a destination folder. So I'm going to make a new folder. I'm going to just throw it on my desktop. And there we go. So there's our destination folder set up. A couple other things to look for is if you want raw file transfer. So make sure it's on or off. If you're shooting JPEG plus RAW or just RAW only, you can change the naming conventions, but I'm going to leave the original file number. Also, just keep in mind up here, it says storage location, memory card plus PC. I'm going to keep them in both places. You can turn this review image on or off, and what that'll do is pop up an image in the Lumix Tether app first. And when you've got those initial settings, just hit save. Let's just go over a few of the settings in this window here. This is your video shutter button, and this is your still photo shutter button. And it just tells you the current camera settings. You can adjust exposure compensation, RAW, fine, picture size, etc. You can even adjust your photo style. Now, you can minimize this by just clicking this arrow here, and it just shows you the shutter button for still photos and video. Now, this little button here is live view. So if you click that one, you can actually see what you're photographing. So I'm just going to move my camera around a little bit so you can see that is what I'm aiming at. So it helps you set up your shot. It's a larger preview, and it also has camera settings down here. So that's sort of a total live preview of your shot. You can add grids, guides. My goodness, there's so many things you can do with the Lumix Tether, and this is awesome. If you are shooting copy work, old photos, it helps you line up your edges. Shooting artwork is an excellent way to use Lumix Tether. And you can even put, if you had a layout, if you're doing advertising work or whatever, and you had a layout, you can select an overlay for your shot as well. So Lumix Tether is very powerful. There's a lot of things that you can use this for, and it's great that you can work on a laptop or a desktop computer, so everything is much bigger. Okay, we'll just close that live view, and we're back to shooting. There we go. There's our shot. Now, if you want to connect your Lumix camera to Luminar AI or Luminar 4, all you need to do is add that folder of images into your catalog. There's my new folder, a tether. I'm gonna add a folder, and those photos are in there. But if I take a new picture, I'll change my scene a little bit. I'll take out the X-Rite card. Gonna go back to Lumix Tether. Just close that, that's our previous photo. Just so you know, this is our setup. Take another picture. Close this, it's out of the way. And you can see that the new photo ended up right directly in Luminar AI. It works the same for Luminar 4. The key is to set up a folder and add that destination folder to your catalog. And that's as easy as it is. So I'm gonna take another picture, just a random shot here. And it automatically pops right into the folder. So that's, in a nutshell, how to shoot tethered, making Luminar your destination for the photos. And one more thing, yes, you can record video. Put it in live view. Just like do some crazy stuff here. Okay, so you record video. You quick stop your video. And then it's going to ask you if you would like to import the video into your destination folder. So you say yes, and it gives you the time. There you go. And if you look into your destination folder, which is a tether, you can see that my video that I just shot is in that folder. Video. There you go. There's my video. If this video has helped you, please subscribe to my channel. And if it's really helped you, please consider buying me a coffee. The link for that is in the video description below. And I want to say thank you so much for those of you who have bought me coffees already. It's awesome to have your support, and thank you very much.